di Antonio Project Zen, Impress Current Cathodic Protection and Sacrificial Load Protection.
Hello everybody, good day and welcome back to my channel. At this time, I will share about hull protection using Impress Current Cathodic Protection or ICCP and Sacrificial Anodic Protection. Before we dive into the discussion about hull protection, we have to know about what is corrosion. Corrosion is one of the most common phenomena that we observe in our daily life. You must have noticed that some objects made of iron are covered with an orange or reddish brown color layer at some point. The formation of this layer is the result of a chemical process known as rusting, which is a form of corrosion. There are many types of corrosion. For example, atmospheric corrosion, erosion corrosion, selective corrosion, uniform corrosion, pitting corrosion, and epicera. Before we continue to watch my animation, don't forget to click like and subscribe button. Your simple contribution by subscribing my channel will give me additional prevention and protection for my ideas for being coded. So, anyway, let's check out my animation. Let's go!
Electrochemical cell or corrosion cell.
Corrosion is usually defined as the degradation of metals into an electrochemical process. Electrochemical process is defined as a chemical reaction involving the transfer of electrons between two electrodes in an electrochemical cell. Electrochemical cell or corrosion cell is a device which converts chemical energy into electrical energy or use electrical energy supply to it to facilitate chemical reaction. There are types of electrochemical cells, as galvanic cell and electrolytic cell. In electrochemical cell, electrons flow from one electrode or anode through an external conductor to second electrode or cathode, driven by an oxidation reduction. In galvanic or voltage cell, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. As you can see on the animation, seeing as anode liberated electrons and place where oxidation reaction occur.
Electron move out from anode. Copper as cathode, the electrons are consumed and a reduction reaction occur. Electron moves into the cathode.
In electrolytic cell, electrical energy transforms to chemical energy. In this cell, feature a positively charged anode and a negatively charged cathode. Electrons originate from external source, such as battery or DC power source.
The process that occurs in electrolytic cell is referred to as electrolysis. During electrolysis, an electrical current is used separate bonded element and compounds. Electrodes are placed in a single solution containing a molten or aqueous electrolyte substance. Electrochemical theory of corrosion.
The fundamental components in electrochemical cell are anode, cathode, electrolyte, and metallic pair. Anode are the electrodes where oxidation occurs, causing it to lose mass or corrode. Oxidation is when a metal atom loses electrons in a chemical reaction with oxygen, forming a metal oxide. Cathode are the electrodes where reduction occurs and electrons are consumed. Reduction is when a metal transfer electrons to some other material, or known also as oxidation reduction, or simplified as redox reaction.
Metallic pad or conducting wire is a metal conductor that is electron over a distance. Electrolyte is electrically conductive solution that must be present for corrosion to occur. An electrolyte contains positively and negatively charged ions called cation and anion, respectively. All four components must be present for corrosion to occur. The ion electrode produces two electrons as it is oxidized. Electrons travel through the wire to copper cathode. The electrons then find the copper ion in solution, and the copper is reduced to copper metal. Seawater is composed of oxygen and hydrogen, and it produces electrochemically negative hydroxyl ions, which can accept the electron given by ion. During reaction, the ion electrode will shrink in size, while the copper electrode will become larger due to the deposited copper that is being produced. So, if this certain condition and element are present, then they accelerate the corrosion and are collectively referred to as the corrosion cell or electrochemical cell. Single form of metal corrosion schematic. A single form of metal can have both an anode part and cathode part. Ship shell made from steel, which is the main component is iron. Iron is an electrochemically positive element and has a tendency to give up electrons to become free ions. Due to the heterogeneity of mild steel in the hull of the ships, along with factors such as non-uniformity of hull group, thickness, paint thickness and quality, variation in the ship structure will change dissimilar metals and oxygen content in seawater, combined to cause areas in the hull to work as cathodes and anodes, and thereby forming a galvanic cell. When a ship's hull floats in seawater, the heated hull with low oxygen concentration turns into the anode, while the other hull with high oxygen concentration becomes the cathode. Anodic reaction that takes place. Ion electrode produces two electrons. Seawater is composed of oxygen and hydrogen, and it produces electrochemically negative hydroxyl ions, which can accept the electrons given by iron. The iron ions combine with hydroxyl ions in seawater to form ferrous hydroxide. This is called the oxidation of iron. This ferrous hydroxide, in the presence of excess oxygen in water, is oxidized to form ferric oxide and water, which we call rust.
Sacrificial anode protection.
How does cathodic protection prevent corrosion? Cathodic protection is a good technique that stops corrosion by burning all the active or anodic spots on a metal surface into passive or cathodic ones. This is done by passing electrons to the metal unit of protection, like a massive steel pipe or a ship's hull. There are two main cathodic protection methods: one, sacrificial anode; two, impressed current cathode protection, or known as ICCP. A sacrificial anode is a metal that is more reactive than the metal it is protecting. A more reactive metal loses electrons more easily, forming ions. For instance, when protecting iron, use a metal that is more reactive than iron, such as zinc or magnesium. The sacrificial anode, also known as galvanic anode, sacrifices itself to protect another metal from corrosion. It oxidizes in the electrolyte, soil or ocean, for example, generating electrons. These electrons flow in the metal being protected, forcing it to become a cathode. Moreover, the incoming electrons help restore the protected metal by reducing any oxidized parts and returning them in their original state. The electrons cause ferrous ions to refer to solid iron. This animation is sample of sacrifice anode for mine condenser to protect tubes which are made from copper or aluminum brass. Sacrificial anode also installed at ship's hull in order to protect hulls from corrosion. Sacrificial anodes corrode themselves to protect the hull. Therefore, it is necessary to be replaced in a certain period. Impressed current cathodic protection. Impressed current cathodic protection or ICCP systems are the technologically advanced and long-term solution to corrosion problems. This method is pretty similar to the sacrificial anode technique, but with a twist. By using an external power source to create the electric current and pumping electrons onto a protective metal to an alternative power source, like a DC power supply, it makes the metal cathode, keeping it safe from oxidation. The best part is it can use any electrically conductive material as an anode, or iron for instance, not plastic, and it doesn't need to replace the anode, unlike in the sacrificial anode protection. In the ICCP, the metal to be protected is connected to an insoluble anode, and the current is passed using a DC source, opposite to the corrosion current, so that the corroding metal gets converted from anode to cathode, and is protected from corrosion. This insoluble anode can be either platinum or platinized titanium. A contact point is taken on the hull of the ship and is connected to a reference electrode, and it is a completely safe insoluble metal. The reference electrode measures the natural corrosion current, which is nothing but the potential difference between the hull and its reference shell. It is necessary to measure corrosion current in the hull so that the supply DC current that is either equal to or slightly greater than it in the opposite direction to the impressed current anode. Ship's ICCP system construction. Ships are often vulnerable to environment corrosion. The seawater where ship sailing containing salt form a perfect electrolyte, with the ship's shell fully made up of iron or mild steel to form a galvanic shell. The application of ICCP on ships to protect hull from corrosion. The ICCP system consists of following parts. Impressed current anodes. The impressed current anodes are usually made up of strong insoluble material like titanium. They may be disc or stripe shaped. Either two or four units are placed symmetrically forward and aft of the vessel. The anodes are welded on Doppler plate onto the hull surface, so as to be completely flush in the outside hull plate. This anode material serves only as a source of electron to the hull and is not consumed in providing this protective current. Reference cell. The electrical potential is monitored by reference electrode assembly, which is fitted port and starboard between the anodes, where the lowest possible potential is likely to occur so as to detect the slightest of corrosion current between the hull and seawater. This reading is feedback to the control panel, which automatically adjusts the impressed current anode output. Remote monitoring panel. A remote monitoring panel located in engine control room is provided, where ICC parameters are monitored and logged down daily. It is to be made sure that the ICCP power source is switched off when the vessel is berthing, or else there is a chance of the ship sensor ICCP system currents to interact with each other, causing hull pain units. Excess of impressed current into the hull surface can lead to the pin peeling off. DC 24 volt output power supply unit. The DC power supply may include a rectifier unit converting 440 volt DC supply to yaitu DC current. Larger ships usually have two power supply units, each in the forward and the aft. The power supply unit is also known as the quantum ICC panel, and it contains a network of thyristors and PCBs, which monitor voltage and current parameters from the reference cells and accordingly send signals to the impressed current anodes. These power units have a master-slave configuration between forward and aft units. Performance can be monitored from ECR monitor panel. The control panel is incorporated with alarms for abnormal readings. Freshwater passage. When a ship moves from seawater to freshwater, its electrical conductivity reduces and its resistivity increases. Because of reduced conductivity, the reference cell will not be able to detect a potential difference. It is important to limit the output protective current from the impressed current anode by manual. When in the automatic control, the ICCP will increase its rectified voltage to a maximum. So, with manual control, has to limit the impressed current and avoid overprotection and save the hull. At terminals, when the ship's ICCP is switched on, ICCP will try to protect the jetty as well by increasing the current in the system, and this can lead to an overload. Hence, the ICCP power source is always switched off in port. Circular and strip anodes emit electrical current into the water surrounding the ship. The current flows through the water by ionic conduction, and then is subsequently delivered back to the power source through the reference cell and systems controller. Hull cleanliness and free from corrosion will reducing fuel consumption, increasing ship speed due to reduced hull resistance, and maintaining hull metal quality for longer interval of time, thereby increasing maintenance interval and cost.
I think that's all my video about impressed current cathodic protection or ICCP and sacrificial anodic protection. Thank you for watching my video. If you think that my video is helpful, don't forget to hit like and subscribe button. Your simple contribution by subscribe my channel is highly appreciated. If you have any question or suggestion, please write your comment down below. Okay, bye-bye. Thank you for watching my video. Antonio Project.